back crashing.
Holy nice. Shit. Nice. GG. Oh my god.
We have successfully changed games without crashing.
Nice.
Which is amazing. I'm very happy. And also, for the next about 2.5-3 hours, with the DKC lads, we are not going to have to change consoles, so we shouldn't crash.
The Danky Kang crew.
It's amazing. Anyway, so I'm going to throw it over to Danky Kang crew to host us out and get us some sweet Donkey Kong action. I'll be with you just for the little donations and color throughout, but I'll throw it over to them now to hold on. I'll just make a check of time, make sure we're not waiting too early. No, that is fine. Go whenever you're ready.
All right. So we're going to be doing Donkey Kong Country. I'm Nathan Tell. This is Neo 53. And yeah.
Oh, sorry. Yeah.
Behind me is Just Your Average Dave and Mercantor. We ready to start?
Yep.
3, 2, 1, go. Alright, so I'm going to be doing warpless, which means I can't use any warps whatsoever, including bonus warps. That was a bit weird. So, the main tech in this game is just rolling, and there's actually a trick where you can extend your rolls. That's called an extendo. Wow. Hello? So this is the first level that's different from like the main category of this game, which is all stages. Usually we take a bonus down there to warp slightly further into the game, but we do not do that. You'll see after I complete each level, I do like a little mash of the face buttons and it skips the fanfare at the end. And here I'll do a little zip through there. It's pretty cool. Oh no. First death. That's fine, this is a fun level. So first water level of the game, not very fun, hardest level in my opinion. Thank you. Good save. Alright, and now for the first boss. The bosses in this game are very difficult, as you can see. Inky, inky, inky hype.
What?
Okay. That's a bit sad.
I'll quickly have that again. 52-50 from Merc, who's sitting like 5 feet away from me. Quote, "I'm not sorry, Neo. Let's put this towards Nomad Songs in your Avatar TLA in the Burning Earth run. Feels bad, man."
Thanks, Merc.
Thanks, Merc.
Alright, so here is probably one of the biggest changes from going from all stages to warpless, because usually we take a warp in here. And this is a very difficult level, as I'm sure you all know from your childhood. And there isn't much tech to this. Nobody can figure out, like, whether it's faster to jump or anything. It's really weird. Ah. All right, one death.
Quickly in the little interim there, VDA Killjoy giving $10.50. He said, they say, "Great to have this event. Sorry I can't give more. Don't be sorry. It's fine. What you give is we are thankful for, and if you're watching, we're even more thankful."
Thank you. Might need that. Alright. That jump there is a bit tricky. It's free. Alright, only one death, that's pretty good. In that level at least.
So this is another really hard level, and there's a bit of a skip you can do at these bees,
yeah.
But that's too hard.
Whoa, good save. Here's another warpless level. Usually we just run left there. It takes us right to the end. Thank you. And here's another Warpless level. Oh yeah. Alright. There's an extender I can do there, but it's inconsistent.
So usually in this level, Nathan would do a trick called a super jump, and that would take him into a warp barrel. But you can't do that. Super jumps will be explained more in World 3.
Yeah. And World 6, unfortunately. Feels bad, man. Wow. That's never happened before.
You've got two excuses left.
Alright. One strike. Yeah, that was some decent RNG. Up next is another Warpless level, followed by another Warpless level. Safety. Hello? This Y button's a bit weird. Randomly presses itself. Okay. Hello? Lucky I got that barrel.
Safety?
Yep. Yep. Why is this happening? Okay. There we go. Nice. That was a great level. Thank you.
First try.
First try. Whoa. I'm not liking the barrel levels with this controller. No, it's not the delay, it's like the Y button randomly presses itself. Yeah, it does. Any button, I'm pretty sure, shoots you out on this one.
can confirm.
I know Y and B do. I don't know about the others. See, like that. Because I was holding Y and I think it just releases itself, maybe. Usually, yeah, that hasn't happened before either. Oh, cool. Of course. Are we gonna game over? Are we on? Like, one?
Yeah, one, I think.
Oh, no. Alright, so here's where that glitch comes in, the super jump.
Nice.
Alright, cool.
Yeah.
That's actually free.
So pretty much, when you kill either Donkey or Diddy next to a wall, they just fly up to the top of the screen, and as soon as you get them back, that momentum is stored. So when you bounce off an enemy, you just fly up.
Should I go for the extender?
Yeah, you've got one life to spare.
Alright, YOLO. No, it didn't work anyway.
That extender doesn't save too much time anyway.
Yeah, probably like a million. No deaths.
Sure you don't want to save?
I might save. So this is another stage that's different in Warpless. Usually we do a trick called Map Warp, where you go back to World 1. Hello. I might save. I'm scared. Especially since Bird Croc is coming up soon. missed that. You can grab the barrel there and like jump. Wow. So I'm trying to get some quick hits on this. Kinda hitting him before he goes back up. What is it, a he or a she? I don't know. Might actually go back into World 3 and save again before I do this. So for those who don't know, my incentive was Birdcroc. It's a weird glitch that I guess you'll just have to wait and see.
So something interesting to note about that boss just then. The left barrel actually causes a frame of lag.
Yeah.
I believe.
Apparently. I don't know why.
So while we're, what do you call it? While we're doing the little save level, Anonymous has given $5.25. Quote, hi, why do Australians copy Americans by speedrunning and having marathons? Good question. We'll get back to you.
Why is our stream upside down? That's pretty wildly confused.
And also, that donation has brought us over the $500 mark, which is a third of the way to our goal in about, what was that, 4 hours?
Yeah.
Which is pretty good. I thank everyone who's been watching and donating and all that.
I was going
to. Well, money's going to go to a good cause, so good stuff.
So, what Nathan was trying to do when he died is called a barrel boost. Essentially, if you grab a barrel and jump on a slope like that, you're able to get a bit extra momentum.
Hopefully I have enough lives to do Birdcroc, because you have to die twice to activate the glitch. Alright, cool, got that extender. There's like a bunch of bananas here, so I think we're alright. I think we get like 2 lives maybe. Not quite, alright, that's fine. Still another level. 2 levels, actually. So, this is another warpless level. Usually we go up, and there's like a warp up there. Yeah!
Nice.
That's a little strat I found. It's probably been found before, I don't know. Oh, I was trying to do it twice. You can do it again there, kind of. Oh well. Still got enough lives for Birdcroc. Nice. I just wanted to show that off again. Gonna chicken out of this one. What? That's not good. Dropped input on the rope there.
So for ropes in this level, will either send you up or down depending on their color. And it can
three
be pretty
times. Yeah. Overall, it's a really fun level, though. There we go.
Nice.
Help. I'm pressing B. This usually isn't too bad, but it's really ridiculous with Donkey. going up the rope there. Alright. Hopefully we get enough lives in this level to actually do Birdcroc. Otherwise, I might have to farm some lives somewhere. I don't know. Usually that isn't a problem. Because nobody goes for Birdcroc. It only saves time in TAS. What? This is going to be interesting. And yeah, we don't have enough lives to do Birdcroc, so I'll probably go back for it.
Can we showcase it after the run?
We could showcase it after the run. So yeah, sorry about that. Yeah.
We got $5.25 from the Fat Cat. Hey, keep going and good luck. I love the cause and wish you all well. Sorry this may come later after my chat post. Also, PCull4444 led me here. Only fair to include him. Well, it is only fair. I wouldn't disprove that at all.
Thank you. Safety. Do you know much about cornering, Nia? Do you want to explain that?
So pretty much how I understand it is if you just cut as many corners as possible, you go faster. That's about it.
Yeah, so the walls are like, as you can see, I'm kind of in the wall a bit, so we try to cut the corner. Save some time. I'm terrible at it though. This hasn't been going too bad. How's the brightness? It's alright.
So you can actually grab squawks in this level and that gives you a bit extra light. But that also adds in a few lag frames.
Alright, I'm gonna check it out. A few is an understatement. It's, yeah, probably a billion.
Nathan, apparently your boy 350 is in the chat.
Yo.
Supporting out.
Shoutouts to DOS. DOS is the other Australian runner of this game. There's a few tie rolls you can do in this level, but I'm chickening out of them because I don't have lives. Okay, I only got half of that.
So just before that tie roll Nathan did, he waited about a second and about just manipulates where the tie spawns.
Yeah, it's a camera manipulation. I was facing the opposite way so that I could get the tire to spawn, so I could, like, roll instantly. Now there's sort of a glitch. I don't know if you'd call it a glitch in this boss. So I switched to Donkey, sacrifice him there, and I can skip it an entire cycle. Obviously we choose the last cycle because the time increases across each cycle. Might grab him just in case. Generally, it's obviously slower to have Donkey. When you're on the Overworld, the game waits for both Kongs to be on the level until you can enter it. Alright, cool. Hello? My cycles were messed up.
So if you land on the edge of these oil drums and roll instantly, nice. You can actually roll over them without getting damaged.
Yeah. And here's another warpless level. Usually we go up there and there's a warp. But we have to play this really, really long autoscroller, unfortunately. Anyone want a banana?
Yeah,
man. Care to pass Merc a banana, Neo?
Sure.
Not quite yet, thank you. Little busy. Throw bananas to the crowd.
Yeah, can you hit me up with some sugar?
You want a banana?
We're getting some bananas.
Have a banana.
Have a banana. Want a banana?
Why not?
Everyone's got bananas.
Nice.
So that was some RNG manipulation for the World 6 boss.
Yeah, for sure. Damn, I'm out of excuses. Oh, that guy doesn't want to come down. Yeah, doesn't want to come for a ride. Neither do these guys really, they just kind of walk off. It's kind of sad.
Shoutouts to going for a ride.
Shoutouts.
Got $3 from PowerMat. I was gonna donate $1.50, but then I noticed this was your half-priced Aussie money, so I doubled my donation. Yeah, the exchange rate's a bit down, but you know.
It's worse in Canada.
Yeah, it was in Canada. There you go.
Oh no.
Judge me in the UK. Either way.
New Zealand,
oh yeah. Either way, thank you for your donation.
Thank you.
Yeah.
So this here is another level that changes. Whoa. In warpless, usually we do a bonus warp up here, but I'm going to go down here and do it the normal route of the level. Go down this way.
Usually we do snake bounce as well.
Sorry. That's unfortunate. Got donkey again. There's a saying in the community that if you're donkey, you're dead. So don't be surprised if I die.
Your donkey's pretty useless.
So, gonna do some real basic strats here, because I don't have Diddy. That was some interesting shit.
So here there's another little trick you can do called elevator skip. It doesn't save too much time.
Nice.
Got it anyway.
Free. Should I save? Yeah, let's save. Whatever. Shoutouts to Candy. Oh, the fly ladies. Shoutouts to my boy Blunt. Alright. If I miss Triple Mince's clip, I'm going to cry. I'm gonna be really devo. Mate. Triple Mince's clip is a trick coming up that, for some reason, I'm kind of known for. I don't know why. I didn't find the trick.
Shoutouts to Joe the Rapper.
Yeah, Joe taught me the trick. Joe taught me everything about this game. Oh my god. Wow. Runs over. Wow. Reset.
So Triple Mincer is a sub-quantum frame pixel perfect trick.
Yep, for sure. Saves like 1 second. And loses like 10. Alright. Wanna explain all this weird stuff I'm gonna do now?
Okay, so pretty much
okay,
if you just walk into the cart as donkey, not jumping, just walking. As soon as you get hit, for some reason, Diddy can just roll through the air. I don't know why that is, though.
For some reason, it kind of ends here, and I have to go into the cart.
So there is another name for that trick, which is hacks. We don't like to use that term here.
What's it called?
Hacks, or cheat code if you prefer.
Oh.
No cheat codes, please.
No cheat codes, please. All right. Didn't die. How many lives have I got? Like 2. That's good. Surely I won't die 3 times. Shout outs to Blackouts. There's no other warpless stuff in this anymore. The rest is identical to all stages. E. One. Two. Three.
So what Nathan was doing there is called a slap slide. It's the most important trick in the game.
Yep. Come on. Hey.
Hey.
Hey. One more? Yeah. Nice. All right.
This level you might see another trick called a jump roll.
Yeah, probably not.
Yep, I'll explain that if you actually get it.
Hopefully I do get it. Yeah, just press Y.
Just go to hit the frame.
Yeah, so you can do a jump roll here. I haven't really explained jump rolls. And there's another one here that I'll go for. No, I didn't get it. There's one more opportunity for me to get one. Well, two, but no. Oh, there's one. So basically you do that through the whole level and it saves heaps of time, especially in this level because it's an auto scroller. Never ends.
So the way I understand jump rolls is if you press Y when you land on an enemy.
Yep, the frame before you hit it.
Yep, the frame before you hit an enemy. You just start rolling through the air. There was another trick that was discovered recently, which is double jump rolls.
And there's also super jump rolls, which is combining jump rolls with super jumps. Ah, we couldn't get that. Okay. Wow. Okay. Why'd you roll? Safety. Alright, we're gonna go back into this level real quick. Grab Diddy. Because I'm gonna do a super jump through that level.
While you're quickly doing that, got a $50 donation from RDJ. And he's asking that we put that entirely to the Kingdom Hearts 2 Out of Bounds Glitch Showcase. I'll do that right now.
Nice, thank you. Alright, there we go. We're just going to fly over this level, because I don't really like it, personally.
So super jumping here is slower, but not by too much.
It's like 5 seconds. Yeah. So usually you'd use Rambi in this level, and it's really weird. You got to like sacrifice him, and it's really complicated. I don't like it. Come down, mate.
So something that we forgot to mention with super jumps. You have to hold B while you're doing them, so you keep going up. You have to release it at a certain time as well.
Yeah.
Otherwise you'll stay up there forever.
There's actually a super jump roll in this level, but I don't like them. And I love this level, so. Thank you. Shoutouts to Eason, world record holder of all stages. 30 to 40, I think.
Yep.
Cool.
So, Lupulates is a pretty interesting stage. It's sort of like a combination of Blackout Basement and Stop and Go Station.
Hmm. Yo! Swedish roll.
Tass only.
Tass only strat right there. Capo. Alright. Hello? No! Alright. I guess the brightness doesn't even matter because I'll be bouncing. Boing, boing.
So I noticed that you rolled through some of those claptraps. How does that work exactly?
This game's just bad. Some of them are programmed as naughty. Alright, Peril's last level in the game. Hype.
You going for dumb jump?
Am I going for dumb jump? Now I'll get Peril's jump roll. Didn't get it. Feels bad, man. Should I go for dumb jump? Hello? Alright, I need to focus. Alright, let's do it. I've got enough lives. Yo! Nice. And shoutouts to Eason, Golden Barrel.
Nice. So now all the devs for Out for Run come together to manipulate the RNG of this boss?
Yeah, for sure.
We'll just get the best on the last cycle. So now we're just up to the final boss, which is of course King K. Rool.
We're gonna swap to Donkey for some nice slap slides. Come on.
So there is actually a world record for the number of slap slides in a row.
Yep.
That's 2 by Jovel Rapper.
That is correct. I've gotten like up to 8 a few times, but can't get close to 2, unfortunately.
It's pretty hard.
Yeah.
So slap slides are actually a frame perfect trick.
It's a triple frame perfect.
Yep.
You have to hold a direction, like left or right, down and Y at the same time.
Oh.
Rip. No more slap slides.
This game has some great music in it, as you can tell. Sour Quiz. Nice.
What's the timer at, by the way?
51:40-5.
We'll still be underestimate.
Yeah.
So we're just gonna sit here. And time. Thank you.
Good.
Yep, let's do Bird Croc.
51:22. Not a bad time.
Yeah, sure. Now we have two Kongs active. Now I want to get Espresso, kill Donkey, and now just enter Croctopus Chase, and there we go.
Nice.
Oh no, come back, come back. Okay, cool. Alright,
there it is, the infamous Bird Croc. So looks like that's going to be it for DKC1, but
yep.
Don't go away, because we've got Donkey Kong Country 2 coming right up, hot in his heels.
Yes.
That'll get set up right now. We're not even going to bother going to a webcam, because I think this should be about 2.5 seconds set up, right?
Basically.
Yeah, we'll just leave that to happen.
Who do you want a mic?
I'll just quickly swap out that layout for you, and we will get right on with the show.
Yeah. I'll take this off.